Let's try this again. Trying to get my stuff on here before I forget, because I'm always forgetting. Did I do it? Good morning! Okay. Sorry, I was trying to get my website pinned there. I'm gonna go ahead and get started as I chat. Forgot to put my mic on. Ah, cool. Thank you. How are you this morning? I'm gonna go ahead and get started because I've got a lot of makeup to do this morning. My name is Carmen, if you don't know. Obviously, it's on there. I am a, besides a wife and a mother, I am a unique presenter, an Orange Status unique presenter. I am not a makeup artist. I'm just a girl who loves to play in makeup. So, okay, I'm going to go ahead and get started just because there's a lot to do. Not really a lot, though. I mean, let's be for real. Good morning, Danette. Sorry, can you guys hear me good? I forgot my mic yesterday. I want to make sure the music's not too loud. Spritz of rose water. This is going to help your face just reduce swelling. It's, it has the most amazing smell. I have been out of this amazing stuff and it has made me so sad. This is our instant lifting serum. This is what I noticed. I got this little guy right here that likes to come in, and it was like fading, I felt. And then I ran out, and it came back, like it started coming back. And it was driving me nuts. So I am really glad to have my instant lifting serum back. I better just leave it there just in case. So I just did a little squirt on here. Good morning, Lori. And then I'm just gonna put it in like the spots that I feel need it the most, like my forehead. Because I am one of those frowny people. You know how there's just some people that, yeah, you see? That right there is where my wrinkle is. I feel like I do that all day long in the classroom. And then I'm going to try something today, and I haven't done this yet, but one thing I noticed since losing weight is I seem to be a little extra wrinkly down here. And we're going to see if we can take some of that away. So normally what I would do if I was not on a Facebook Live, I would run downstairs and refill my coffee, or I would go do something with my hair or fiddle on the computer, because you want to give this some drying time. Did you want to see what mug I have today? Mom. These mugs are amazing. Just saying. But you should not go look for them. Don't find any of the mugs. Save it all for me. The ladies are, there's like been fights in TJ Maxx and Marshalls, because women are fighting over the Ray Dunn. It's crazy. Sorry. if you're tuning in, say hi, tell me where you're watching from. Feel free to hit the share button. I mentioned the other day when I use BB Flawless, it's a tinted moisturizer. That's what I feel it is. It's a BB cream. I usually do not use moisturizer. I've always shared that when I do the instant lifting serum, I like using the moisturizer because it kind of rubs, you know, mixes it in. But I'm not going to do that today. I am going to go on. I apologize for the sniffles. I'm not sure why we woke up with the sniffles this morning, but we did. So I'm going to take a little bit of the BB cream, and I'm just going to use, I use this mirror here. I'm just going to put that there. Now, one thing you can do, if you're looking for more coverage, let's say, you can do one or two things. You can drop in some concealer on top of the BB or liquid foundation. So I'm going to drop a little bit of liquid foundation. So I literally put, if I can get that second drop, I'm on my, I put two drops of liquid foundation, and then I'm just going to mix it together. If you're liking the music, it's Vitamin Strings on Pandora. It's great study music for your kids. There's no words. It's awesome. Now I'm just going to blotch it all over, make sure I get my hair back here. I love the BB cream during the winter because my face is so dry. I am still coughing. This cold that is going around, it's crazy. Because I'm still coughing after like 3 weeks. So I'm literally going to do this, like, you know what I just realized I forgot? Primer. Ugh. Oh well. It happens. You gotta love when that happened, right? Sorry for the sniffles, guys. Not sure why they started this morning. Okay. And then when you're using your brush, you should always use with a light hand. You don't want to be pressing it. And always be sure to cover this. You want your eye the color of your skin, right? Just gonna make sure we're blending it down here. Make sure you go down your neck. Okay. And it definitely makes a difference not using the primer. I am not gonna lie. But that's okay, it happens. Okay, so that's it. BB cream is really like a medium coverage. I really just want something that is going to even my skin tone. Okay, but I do recognize I have a little blemish here. All right, hold on 1 second. So I am going to mix a tiny bit of chiffon, because chiffon is more like the color of the BB cream. But because I lightened it up a little bit, I'm going to put a tiny bit of velour in there. Hi, Norm. Thank you. I have got, the sniffles this morning. So we talked yesterday when I did my foundation. We were talking about how to choose the concealer you want. So, like I mentioned to Danit, the chiffon is really going to kind of match my foundation. And if you want it to cover a blemish like that right there, then that's what you want to go with. So, I'm going to let that just sit there for a moment. Then I have one little spot right there. And we're just going to let that sit. And we are going to go on to brows. I got my brows done. I mentioned yesterday. They do not take as much work now, which is amazing because it makes life much easier and I can get my brows done like super duper quick, which I'm all about that, I'm not gonna lie. So what I'm going to show today, I forgot to mention this in the beginning. Today is my Wake Up to Makeup. If you watch my post, I am doing like, I'm going to try and get on about 5 days a week. And I don't really want to fill a whole bunch in because I don't feel like I need it as much. So I'm just going to try and hit some of the spots. When I do my top line, I like to comb this down a little bit so I can get in there. I'm gonna try and hit on something 5 days a week at least. My Saturdays are now devoted to rugby. So today is my Wake Up to Makeup. That means I am showing you from beginning to end. So see, that's all it took for the brow, that's it. Always give it a quick little brush through because you don't want to have like the brush marks. I do have that one spot that's driving me bonkers. There we go. So I'm going to come in with the dark. This is the Brow Obsession palette. Absolutely love this palette. Little tip, I hold it upside down so the dry powders do not fall in the creams. So I'm going to take a little bit of the dark and come in on my little tail end. And I'm going to move kind of fast today because we are doing a full face day. So here's the difference between my very quickly done brow and then my not done brow. Thank you everyone for joining. Feel free to say hi. Tell me where you're watching from. I know Norm is watching from Wichita, Kansas. Feel free to hit the share button. Hey. Excuse me. Tell you, I don't know what got in here today that I started the sniffles. No matter where I go, I've got allergies. We're gonna comb this down. Hi, Liz. Now this side, we are working on getting a little more growth right there to kind of match this one. To match, not... Remember what my friend Janae, the esthetician, said yesterday? Your eyebrows are sisters, not friends. But we do kind of want them to have some of the same, right? So we're going to use a little bit of the dark to fill in there. And if you make a mistake, it's totally okay because... we've got that magic little, this right here. All right, guys. I'm gonna scooch over here real quick because I do not want to blow my nose on camera. Okay. Now, this that we mixed in here, we're going to buff that in now. So I'm just going to take this and we're just going to buff it, okay? Got to take some more of that off here. Because you do not want it to stand out. That's why you want it, the concealer for a blemish, the same color. Hi, Mama, you're up early. Mom, look at my new mug. Mom. All right, let's finish these brows. So I went a little up over here and I wanted to show how you can take that little piece of the pink and use it as, I like to call it an eraser or a fixer, you could say. So that's what that is. And I use the Brow Artist brush. So the angled side is what I use for the application of the brow powders. This is the side I use as my little fixer. And you don't need a lot. You only need like a little tap. So I always end up having to use it right here. Good morning, Sonia. And I always like to highlight there. I always will rub it in just a tad, and then I'm just going to get a little bit on the other side. Now, this is the side that I need to kind of fix that little angle there. There we go. Now, I am going to just use a little bit of the wax. I'm not going to use the highlighter right now, and then I'll tell you why in just a moment, because my cream shadow is going to pretty much act as my highlighter. Alright, so before I comb out my brows, I am going to put a little bit of our eye primer on my eyes and let that sit while I brush out my. Now you should, when you do anything around, underneath, or over the eyes, you should use your ring fingers. I am just very gently using these. The skin around your eyes is very, very sensitive. And when you use your ring fingers, you just have a gentler touch. I'm going to tell you why. Because I got a wart. I have a wart right there that the doctors can't get it off, like nothing can get it off. So I don't want to put that like on my face. So that's the real reason. Now you all know that's the reason I do not use my ring finger, because it freaks me out. That's it. Janae, I was just talking about you again. Okay, so now you all know why I will not use my ring finger. I'm not sharing that again. You have to watch a replay to find out. But okay, we're moving on. So I put the eye primer on. So while that gets on, I am moving on to my Lazy Woman's Contour. Okay, so I just need my bronzer. Good morning, Janae. Just finished my brows. You and I talked about the brow palette. So that's the brow palette. It's got a little mirror, and then it's got, this is what it comes with. Yeah. Love it. And I love my brows. I'm so glad I found you. So, okay, so beachfront bronzer. We're going to do a little pinch. And I get to see you, Janae, today. If you were there today, I see Monica this afternoon. And now you want to go right under the cheekbone. Okay, so we're just going to push it in there, and then we're going to push it up. Then we're going to go do the other side. But I love haircut day. And then we're going to push it up. Here we go. Good morning, Laura. Laura, oh my gosh, girl. If you're just joining, feel free to say hi. Tell me where you're watching from. Laura, that traffic on Cuyama. So we're going to do the Lazy Woman's Contour. So first I'm going to put it up here. And then we're going to do our three in our seat. Get it in there. You get your hair did today. So do I. I'm so excited. Alright, so I'm just going to leave that right there for right now. If you tuned in yesterday, you got to see the new technique for the under the eyes. And let me tell you, if you watched or if you looked, trying to check and see how we are on time. If you looked at my pictures, there's definitely a difference with the before and after. Yeah, Laura, it was insane. I don't drive that much, and I was not happy driving it, for reals. I put a little bit of concealer on my hand because we want to get it warmed up, and then I am packing it on my brush. And then I am just going to get it on here. Remember we talked about doing the triangle? So really you're going to go in here and up. Then we're going to go do the same thing on this side. And then maybe if I get this technique down, I'll be really, really good at it. I apologize again for the sniffles. Oh my gosh. Okay. So there is, I mean, there may look changing mine up. How about you? I'm changing something up, but these sniffles are like driving me insane. And I am so sorry. There's just really nothing I can do about it. You really need to. Janae, I don't know if you saw yesterday in the comments. I put the before and after. I definitely saw a difference. My blood pressure is measuring. Maybe I need to take a little breather. Okay, so I like to let it sit because our concealer, and I do not remember all the exact wording. It's a cell. Hold on. It's a skin perfecting concealer. So it has like these particles that like blend into your skin. But you definitely want to let it warm up a minute. So we're going to take one more sip. All right. So I've got that on there. And now I'm going to take my concealer brush. I'm going to take the concealer side. And then he says you want to get all the way into the nose. And then I had not done my eyeshadow yet, but I'm going to do it anyways because I'm doing a neutral eye, so it's really going to be very light. Sometimes you do the lives, you just get a little confused. I was like, oh my gosh. I still get nervous, y'all. Not going to lie. No, I'm going to wipe it off some. I feel like I'm going out of order. No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Blending. No, I'm not. Now, Wayne Goss had this really cool, I think he used his, and it's his brand of brushes. I think it was the number 19. I love him. But I do love this concealer brush, and I feel like it is going to buff it into the skin too, so. Okay. Yeah, it was huge brightening. I thought, I'm going to take my unused tissue, I promise you. And then we're going to dab it off. But, ooh, you know what this means? If I dab it off, because I forgot to do my eyeshadow, is I can show you the other trick. So, just going to dab, even just doing that, look at the difference. Not a lot comes off, but definitely enough. And then you're going to take your itty-bitty blending brush that hopefully, you know, maybe you've got an 18-year-old daughter who has those and you can get it from. You always want to have it damp. So if you're in your restroom or in your, you know, around your sink, you can damp it with your sink. I have my rose water here, so I just dab it with rose water. And then you're just lightly going to tap, 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 tap. Wonder if I can take a drink and tap, tap, tap. And try not to slurp in your... Yeah, I definitely saw a difference, Janae. And I was kind of surprised about how easy it was because I can kind of be a dork sometimes. And it does help set it. This is what he said. And mate, you know what? I'll get his link and show you. When you do your concealer, you don't want your concealer, like normally most people would put it on and just smear it, you know, or whatever and rub it in. He said you're working it into the skin. So every step, when you first apply it and then you buff it into the skin, because you don't want it to look like it's laying on top. And then when you take off the excess, and then you're working it into the skin. So he's, you know, that's what we're doing. We're working it in. So it's in our skin, not laying on top. So definitely, I think it helps do both, really, because you are blending it in. Because look how blended in it is now just by doing that. So I'm going to come in one more time with this and blend my Lazy Woman's contour. And then I'm going to come in with the excess that's on here. Remember, this is the Lazy Woman's contour, because then we're going to blend. We're going to blend some of this in, but I feel like I need a little bit more. And when you're not wearing glasses and the writing is really small. Oh, nice. Someone wants to join my video. I'm sorry, dude. I don't know you, but if you want to learn about makeup, feel free to tune in. So, Lazy Woman's contour. It's something, if you've watched me, you know this is something that I do. Because, I mean, I love our contour palette, our sculpting trio, but, I mean, really, who has time to do all that in the morning? Like, for reals. Okay, so I'm going to do a neutral eye today. Now, I did not use the, as I mentioned earlier, I did not use our highlighter. Ooh, where is this? Because... the cream shadow that I am going to use all over, if I can find it, there it is. Good morning, Chris. It is going to act like my highlighter. This is my favorite cream shadow. I use it all the time. And almost, it's definitely an everyday look. I do not know what color I used last on my eyeshadow. Yeah, I do. It was yesterday's. But I'm going to use our brush cleaner and just spray it off real quick. Rub it on our towel. Then I can use my brush again. That's so amazing. Okay, so I'm just going to give it a clean off. This is just like a really nude. It's a great all-over shade. So I'm just going to plop this on here and definitely help line the brows. I am just going to do a neutral eye today, and then I am going to use our crushed lip powder on my eye. And I don't know about you, but I always have to like, so look at the difference right there. Just, this is definitely one that you can use as a highlight and an all over palette. So it's like a twofer. You're getting like a two for one, because this is just my absolute favorite cream shadow that you definitely can use in your makeup bag every single day. Because I would totally just do this and do like a liner. Good morning, Miss Tammy. I voted on your bedding. That was fun. Good morning, Claire. If you're popping on, feel free to tell me where you're watching from. Feel free to hit that share button. All right, so let's see. What are we doing? Oh, I know what I'm doing. So this last week when, you know, I was on winter break, not wearing any makeup, I got one of our new little, it comes in a quad. You can also get it in a quad palette. I decided to start with one. This is an Astute. I'm going to use this as my neutral today. So I'm going to get my amazing blending brush. Again, I'm not sure what color I used on it. So I'm just going to just give it one little spritz. And I'm just going to rub it on the towel, because who knows what color I used on it last time. And if I use something different, I don't want to, when I'm using a neutral, But that's what's amazing about this brush cleaner is you can use it, clean your brush, and then use your brush again. So that's awesome. All right, this color is Astute. So I'm going to take our blending brush. I like to call it my magic brush because it is real magic. This is like the easiest blending tip ever because we're just going to go like this. And like my friend Kelly says, we're like just going to windshield wiper it on. You're just going to blend it. So it's applying and it's blending. And that's it. Like that's going to be my eye right there. Okay, gonna do a little bit higher. And remember, if you are, I know because there's so many different type of eyelids, you do not want to go like this because then you're gonna apply it like that. You want to be sure because you want it to be a little bit higher. You want to look straight into the mirror when you do it. Because I know before I would always do it. So see, look at that. Oh, have a great day, Laura. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting Kelly and I always. You're awesome. See, we always go to do like this. It's one of those habits. It's like one of the, you know, it's one of those habits that you do for so long because you think you're doing it right. And I'm just going to blend. And that's the best thing about putting on just my friend Kelly. Kelly, I was just talking about you. My friend Kelly, here she is. She is my go-to makeup gal. She is amazing. Look what I'm using. You do that? What do you do, Kelly? Because I forgot what I said. Oh, you're talking about when we go like this? Well, we all do. And when I read that, because I try to learn little tips, because I have not always been like a makeup person. So I do try to learn some stuff. And I learned that and I was like, oh, wow, do I do that? And then what I realized, because I was doing this, I literally was getting it only right there. So when you start looking like this, oh, look, you can get up there. And then you really do highlight right under the brow, right? Kelly, you were right. This color is amazing. So now I just need to figure what color I'm going to use as my... Can you come to Vegas with me and do your makeup? Oh, Melissa. Ooh, you know what I'm going to do? Oh, I'm going to do something different. I love Vegas. I'm not going to lie, Vegas is one of my favorite places. I am going to grab my angle brush. I'm going to clean it because, again, I don't know what color I used. I was trying to decide because I do not, you need some serious help? Girl, I can help you out. I am going, Kelly, you got to tell me if I'm wacky. I'm going to use the Unashamed. I don't have my glasses on. And yes, they're bifocals. Shh. So I need them to read. But I'm going to use that as my liner. I do not use, I've talked about this before, I do not use an eyeliner pencil. I use my... Okay, good. Kelly and I love to do Facebook Lives together. She teaches me so much. And who doesn't love like a makeup buddy that you can chat about makeup with? We just got to get our schedules figured out to be able to do them together. So remember what I talked about yesterday, the technique. What I should have done is done the concealer after, but you know what? I have a tip that I'll share for next week. So when you're, this brush, it is, so you're going to think I'm a nut. Watch this.
Okay. Shh. Don't tell anybody, but look. I have three. So, truth is, Kara had one. She left but one behind, and I found it. But what I do is I have two. Can you tell why? I am a hoarder. This is what I use for my dark, like my dark black, my browns. This is the one that I use. And then this is for my lighter shade. And then, you know, that other one I just found when I was cleaning out one of Kara's cabinets. I was like, oh, makeup brushes. That's where I found this one. And I stole it. But I figure, you know what? Hi, Chris. I figured she left it behind. So I like the soft look. So I'm going to take, and yeah, Janae, this brush is amazing. I'm going to take my shader side very gently. Just give it a little brush. Finders keepers, losers weepers. That's right. That's all I'm doing today. I am going to do, I lied. I'm going to do a little bit of the beaming this hair, and we're going to use that as our little highlighter. So I'm going to take the opposite side. And just get the inside corner, and then I'll show you why in just a moment. And then we'll do some mascara and lips really quick. Ooh, oh, we're doing okay on time. I don't know if Bryson's up for school, but okay, so this here, so this is the side with the inner corner with a little bit of shimmer. Can you tell the difference? Because I know I can. And when it's daylight, usually you can tell a big difference, but you know. It's still dark outside. But I do love a little shimmer in there. You're never too old for shimmer. Bye, Kelly. Have a great life, sweetie. And I will chat with you later. I started the process we talked about yesterday with the download, that new way to do that. So that is all I'm doing on my eyes. It's a very neutral eye because I'm going to have a pop of color with my lips. And yes, I still use a torture device on my lashes. And you don't want to just squeeze it. You can do like little pulls and hold up, but don't just squeeze them off. You want to do it very safely because you do not want to use your lashes. But I hear there's this amazing lash serum that you can get. You may know a girl who has a connection. But I really do like to use my lash curler because my lashes grow straight out. And I have a, you know, the blow dryer trick. If you watch me, got a little piece of something. I always have my blow dryer here because I use my blow dryer for my lashes. But Bryson was working on his, I always comb out my lashes before I put my mascara on. Bryson stole my blow dryer because, good morning, Ricky. He was working on my little shark picture I posted the other day that he painted me. And he stole it. So now I have no blow dryer for my lashes. I'm using the Epic Mascara. And then we are just going to do some quick luminizer. Happy week to everyone. We went back to school yesterday. Boy, I was exhausted. But it was a good day. You can tell the kids are all a little wacky. I'm going to do two coats, so I'm going to put on this one, give them a comb through. I feel since I started using the lash serum, my lashes have changed so much. Bye, Janae. I'll see you later. I need to get my next appointment set up with you. Iron Scissors Salon. Janae, help a sister out. Does amazing. All right. Okay. I just love this mascara. It is so amazing. And it's so easy. And if I really wanted, you know, Melissa, we were talking like about Vegas. If I was going to do Vegas lashes, I would also combine the Epic Mascara with our 3D Mascara. Because you're going to get even more volume. And you're going to make them nice and long and gorgeous. So there we go. All right. So now I am going to use, let's see. I am going to use setting powder today. And I'm going to use Kara's brush I stole. So this is what we're using. We're using the Behold Translucent Setting Powder. So I'm just going to use this all over. And the reason I'm using this instead of my setting spray is because I used the BB cream. So I'm just testing to see out, because my face gets oily later in the day. So I'm just testing it out to see like what works best. I'm just going to put a little extra in there. And that's it. That's all you have to do. And that is not a lot. That seems amazing. But I did just realize I forgot to use a quick pinch here. All right, we are going to do some illuminizer, and then we're going to go on to the lips. And we're doing crushed lip powder. I think that's the color I'm going to go with. Hopefully it matches my pants. So we're just going to put this right under here. You want to just put it, not lightly, if you've got a lot of wrinkles right in here, you do not want to put it there. You want to put it down below. We don't want to highlight those nasty little critters that pop up. I'm going to do it just a little bit on the nose. A little bit on the lip. Okay. So that's done. Let's move on to the lips. Okay. Now with this crushed lip powder, you can use a lip liner. I think this is the color I'm going with today. Yeah. Hopefully it kind of matches. All right. This is only out for this month. This is what it is. They're like micro beads, like itty bitty teeny weeny pockets of like colored water. So when you put it on, because it's a powder right now, you can see inside it's a powder. I do not know how long it lasts because, you know, we just got them in. But from the looks of it, it's going to last a really, really long time. So when you first pull it out, it is a powder. You can see it dust off. See? You can see it dust off there. So I'm just going to take this and always start with my top. It blows me away as it goes on warm. Good morning, Amy. All right. And it literally turns like creamy. It is the craziest thing. So I kind of used my top for my bottom. So I'm just going to line up, make sure they're lined. And you can use a lip pencil. Okay. That's it. This stuff is amazing. So we'll watch how long it lasts. The last time I shared it with y'all and I posted, or I did a Facebook Live when it first came out. I mean, we took it off because we were home. And so let's see how long it lasts for a day. I'm going to use a little bit of this. Highlight on lip again. And I'm excited. I'm excited to see how this is going to last. Normally, I would put my Hottie Lip Plumper over whatever I'm using, but I'm not going to do that today because I want to see, you know, how it works. So that's it. I shared with you my Ray Dunn mug. It's a mom mug today. We'll have a new one tomorrow. That's all. That's my neutral eye look. I absolutely love it. The pop of color on the lips. Thank you guys so very much for watching. I'm shooting for 5 days a week. You're gorgeous. Hi, Melissa. Thank you for staying. Oh, you're so sweet. I just realized I forgot a before picture. Forgot a before picture, but I'll post the after picture, and I'll try to get one when we actually have, like, daylight. But that's it. Thank you so much for watching. What is tomorrow? Tomorrow is... Today's Wednesday, right? Today is Wednesday. So tomorrow's Thursday. Tomorrow's eyes. I'm just going to show an eye look. Good morning, Shelby. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for watching. I truly appreciate the support. Feel free to hit that share button. I'm totally okay with that. If you like any of the products I use today, you can contact your favorite unique presenter or you can contact me. My website is pinned, beuniquebycarmen.com. It's right here in my picture frame. Can y'all see that? Right now for me, it's like all covered up. Oh, thank you so much. It's just easy. Does, like, we've been on for not quite an hour, but you know, when you're talking and having coffee, you know, it's okay to just take a little bit longer. This is like my hour for like me and my makeup and to spend my time with you guys. So that's it. You guys have a terrific Wednesday. It's hump day. And that's all. Have a great one. And your cup. So this is my newest obsession. I don't know if you've heard about it. I really don't want to like tell people because I don't want you to go rush Home Goods and TJ Maxx and Marshalls and buy all the Ray Dunn. Happy Wednesday. But if you're local and you are at TJ Maxx, Marshalls, or Home Goods, and you see any Ray Dunn in the large lettering, every mug is different. I only have two mugs that are the same. And you find any, you gotta call me. Call me. Because I may need you to pick it up. Have a terrific Wednesday. Peace out.